Hi, Garrick. It's great to see you.
Thank you, Ashton. It's an honor to be with you again. Garrick, let's head out to the studio.
Yes, let's go.
What's our topic about this evening, Garrick?
It's about decoding general medicine.
Fantastic.
Good evening, and welcome to our in-depth discussion series, where we explore the ins and outs of general medicine. I'm Dr. Garrick Pattenden, and with me is the esteemed Dr. Ashton Drake. Tonight, we're unpacking medical jargon and common health myths to empower you with clear, actionable knowledge.
It's a pleasure to join you, Garrick. There's a wealth of medical terms and health advice out there, and it can be overwhelming. We're here to clarify these terms and debunk the myths so you can make informed decisions about your health.
What is general medicine?
General medicine is the bedrock of patient care, encompassing a broad spectrum of diseases and conditions. It's what most people think of when they consider going to the doctor.
Ashton, in your experience, what is the most misunderstood aspect of a general practitioner's role?
Well, Garrick, people often think of a GP as merely a gateway to specialists, but GPs manage complex chronic conditions, perform procedures, and provide holistic care. They're not just gatekeepers. They're expert clinicians in their own right.
Moving on to preventative health. It's about more than just avoiding sickness. It's a proactive approach to maintaining long-term wellness. Ashton, can you expand on the concept of preventative screenings and why they're so vital?
Screenings are critical tools for early detection of diseases like cancer, diabetes, and heart disease. Early detection often means more effective treatment and better outcomes. For instance, colonoscopies can detect precancerous polyps before they turn into colon cancer.
Understanding symptoms. Symptoms are the body's way of signaling that something might be amiss. Ashton, let's discuss red flag symptoms that should prompt immediate medical attention.
Certainly, Garrick. Symptoms such as sudden chest pain, difficulty breathing, severe headaches, or unexplained weight loss can indicate serious underlying conditions and should never be ignored.
First aid basics. First aid is a crucial skill set. Ashton, let's talk about recognizing and responding to a stroke, which is time sensitive and requires immediate action.
Stroke recognition can be remembered by the acronym FAST: face drooping, arm weakness, speech difficulties, and time to call emergency services.
Quick response can save brain function and lives. Navigating healthcare. Healthcare systems can be labyrinthine. Ashton, what advice do you have for patients trying to navigate the system more effectively?
Knowledge is power here, Garrick. Patients should understand their health insurance coverage, keep records of their medical history, and not hesitate to ask their doctors about any uncertainties regarding referrals or treatments.
Medication safety. Medication safety is a topic that can't be overstressed. Ashton, let's discuss the importance of understanding drug interactions.
Drug interactions can alter the way medications work and may lead to serious side effects. For example, blood thinners can have dangerous interactions with over-the-counter pain relievers, leading to an increased risk of bleeding.
Now, before we get into this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a comment below saying I subscribed. I will reply to your comments as soon as possible, and this brings us into the next part of this video. Myth-busting segment. Now, let's bust some myths. There's a lot of misinformation out there, especially on the internet. Ashton, what's a common myth you encounter in your practice?
A prevalent myth is that sugar causes hyperactivity in children. Numerous studies have shown no link between sugar intake and hyperactivity. It's a persistent belief, but it's not supported by scientific evidence.
Here's another. Cracking your knuckles causes arthritis. Ashton, what does the evidence say?
Research shows that knuckle cracking does not increase the risk of arthritis. It might annoy those around you, but it's unlikely to harm your joints. And what about the idea that going out in the cold weather without a coat will cause a cold? Colds are caused by viruses, not cold weather. While being cold can stress your body, it's not the temperature alone that causes you to catch a cold. It's exposure to the virus. Let's continue debunking with the belief that everyone needs to drink 8 glasses of water a day. Hydration is more complex than a one-size-fits-all approach, isn't it, Ashton? The amount of water you need depends on many factors, including your health, activity levels, and where you live. Thirst is actually a pretty good indicator of when you need to drink more. And a classic, reading in dim light ruins your eyesight. Good lighting helps to avoid eye strain, but there's no evidence that reading in low light causes permanent eye damage. Eating turkey makes you sleepy because of tryptophan. Is this true? Tryptophan is involved in sleep and mood regulation, but the sleepiness after a big turkey dinner is more likely due to the large intake of calories and carbs. We often hear that we only use 10% of our brains. What's the reality? Neuroimaging has shown there's no part of the brain that remains inactive. Even simple tasks require more than 10% of our brain capacity. And crossing your eyes can make them stay that way? Your eye muscles are designed to move your eyes in all directions. They won't get stuck just because you cross them. Vaccines causing the illnesses they're meant to prevent. Myth or fact? Vaccines stimulate the immune response, not cause disease. Some vaccines contain inactivated viruses that cannot cause illness. Eating carrots improves your vision. Myth? Carrots are high in vitamin A, which is important for eye health, but they won't give you 20/20 vision or improve eyesight that's already impaired. And finally, sitting too close to the TV is bad for your eyes. Modern screens are much safer, and while sitting close can cause eye strain, it doesn't cause permanent damage. We've covered a lot of ground today, from the role of general medicine to the importance of recognizing serious symptoms and the truth behind common health myths. Ashton, any parting words for our viewers? I'd like to remind everyone that while the internet is a valuable resource, it's also filled with misinformation. Always consult with a healthcare professional before making any significant changes to your health regimen. Thank you, Ashton, and thank you to our viewers for tuning in. Remember, an informed patient is a healthier patient. For more detailed discussions on medical topics, make sure to subscribe to our channel and join us as we continue to explore the world of medicine. Thank you for spending time with me too, Garrick. Anytime, my friend. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay informed.